Unit 5, Engineering, Geology. So in this topic, we are going to study about the part 2, which means the second part of the subject, second part of the unit. Here, dependency of bearing strength of rocks on texture and structure will be studied. So here, the introduction of the rocks will be taught first. The rocks are naturally solid, massive aggregates of minerals forming the crust of earth. So rocks are solid massive objects which are forming the crust of earth, and rocks are having very high compressive strength and it is able to bear loads. The compressive strength of the rock depends upon the factors like formation, composition, texture, structure and moisture content and extent of weathering. Weathering represents the exposure of the rock towards the sun, heat, cold, air, wind, water and all the forces of nature. Here, the mode of formation, the rock can be igneous, the rock can be sedimentary, the rock can be metamorphic. The next composition, the basic minerals which forms the rocks are highly important. Next comes texture. What kind of texture the rock is having? Either it is fine grained, very big, larger grains or medium grains. And next comes the structure. The structure, it may be porous, it may be watertight. The next comes moisture content. The moisture content is important because if there is moisture present in the rock will be having very less strength. At the same time, if the rock which is having very low moisture content, where the packing of materials or the interlocking molecules will be tight, resulting in very high compressive strength. Next comes texture of igneous rock. So here the texture is having a mutual relationship between mineralogical assembly or mineralogical content. So it is again determined by size, shape and arrangement of interlocking crystals. There are five common textures in igneous rock. Those are phanaritic, which is coarse grained, fine grained, aphanitic. Next comes porphyritic. Porphyritic, that will be a mixture of both coarse grained and fine grained structures. Next comes glassy and vesicular. Vesicle represents long tube like holes or porous structure. Glassy, I think you all know well how glasses will be. Next, structure of igneous rock. The structure is formed by intrusion or extrusion of igneous rock. Either the structure is formed in the surface or below the surface of earth. Next comes the types of structures available in igneous rock is flow structures, pillow structures, rocky and blocky lava structure, spherulitic structure and orbicular structure. The spherulitic structure, that will be having minerals which are grouped together in a particular assembly. Next one, orbicular structure, that will be formed due to the minerals which are assembled in a different pattern. So this assembly of minerals take places due to the cooling effect and different cooling temperatures and times of cooling. So due to this kind of external factors, the structures are determined. Next comes texture of sedimentary rock. So sedimentary rock, the texture of a sedimentary rock depend on a number of factors. First thing, it comes as origin of grains. Either it can be clastic or non-clastic in texture. Clastic means the material which are formed as a mass due to the rolling of the particular base rock material over a region. Next comes size of grains, then again coarse grain, medium grain, fine grain and shape of the grains. The shape of the grains results in breccias and conglomerates. Then next comes packing of grains. Either it can be open packed or it could be or porous. Then fabric of grains, whether the grains are arranged vertically or horizontally. Next comes crystallization. Then the granular structure could be crystalline or amorphous. Amorphous represents there will be different materials combined together to form a granular structure. Next comes structure of sedimentary rock. So here the sedimentary rock masses are formed are having a different structure and these structures are classified into types. First comes stratification, layered arrangement, which means every layer of mineral that will be deposited over a period of time and it will become as a rock due to the action of natural forces. Next comes lamination. So lamination layers will be very thinner, that will be less than a centimeter in thick. Then next comes cross bedding. Cross bedding means the layers will not be parallel to one another, that may be zigzag or that may be undulations present in the cross bedding layers. Next comes graded bedding. So here the bedding depends upon the grain size, which means there will be different layers of grains that will be present in the different layers of the sedimentary rocks. Next comes texture of metamorphic rock. So there are two types of texture available in metamorphic rock. First one is crystalloblastic texture. So here the rock, while it undergoes metamorphism, this kind of texture will be formed. Either it could be granoblastic or porphyroblastic. So granoblastic means the texture of the grain sizes will be same and the rock will be formed from granite. Next one, porphyroblastic. The porphyroblastic represents mixture of small and both bigger grains. Next comes palimpsest or relict textures. So this kind of texture will be present in the parent rock despite metamorphic changes. So the example is blastopyritic. Next comes structure of metamorphic rocks. Some common structure found in metamorphic rocks are cataclastic structure. It will be called as myelonite and slate in rocks. Schistostructure, mica schist, mesostructure, banded gneisses, and maculostructure, hornfels, granulostructure, granulites. So you in the diagram which is given in the lower end of this slide represents the increasing temperature and increasing pressure. And the rocks which are present in between these two axes shows the changes of rocks. First, shale, that will be a low grade clay rock that will get converted to slate, and again slate due to increase of temperature and pressure that will result in schist. Again schist will result in formation of gneiss. Gneiss will result in the formation of migmatite. So that will be very high grade. And you can see there is one more classification of schist called blue schist. So that is due to increasing pressure, but the temperature effect will be very low in them. Next comes the dependency of bearing strength on texture and structure. So because the rocks are able to bear very high strength, it is suitable to construct your dams and bridges over a very high bearing capacity rock. But if the texture of the rock varies or if the texture does not support, that will result in the collapse of bridges, dams, whatever you are constructing over the base rock. Then igneous rock, being compact and interlocking in texture and uniform in structure, have very high compressive strength compared to sedimentary and metamorphic. In sedimentary and metamorphic rocks, abundance of planes of weaknesses are available because sedimentary rock will be formed in different layers and that will cause weakness between the bedding planes, and combined with foliation, schistosity, cleavage, that will affect greatly the strength of rock. Again, the metamorphic rock which is formed from sedimentary rock will also have these same weaknesses in them, making it unsuitable. So here are some examples of the rocks and their types and their respective compressive strength. So this compressive strength is uniaxial, which means from the top side to the bottom side the pressure will be applied, then the rocks will be tested for their strengths. And thank you for your patience. The next topic will be rock weathering and soil formation. Once again, I thank all the valuable works of intellectual peoples, those who have posted their contents online, and I'm again using the same contents to prepare this slide. Thank you and best of luck.